guys, welcome back to another very exciting tutorial of creating process. And in today's video, we design this logo. We can see there's two shades of color, one is pink and one is white, and we can also see a nice pattern of circles above it. And if the overall formation of this logo is combination of two alphabets, that's T and A, where T is the visible part and A is invisible part. So to create this logo, we'll follow the following steps. First, we'll create this shape of A from the fonts, then we'll create the T portion from our basic shapes using the polygons, then we'll subtract it from there. Maybe you can use the shape builder too also. Then after that, we'll create this nice pattern of circles, and then after that we'll subtract it from the overall design, and finally we'll add the grading colors and the colors and the text. So let's begin with our tutorial. So let's take the font type A and make it white and scale it up, and we are using for this font A, we are using this Utsha. So in this we'll write UDS, and you can see you got that. And then after that, instead of regular, we are using bold. Scale it up, go to object and expand this to convert this into object form. And once you have converted this into object form, we'll tweak this a little. So zoom it in with the delete anchor point tool. Just delete these extra unwanted points here. We don't need this, so we're just deleting this. Or you can just go in there and just delete this portion, delete these points, this and this. So, and after that, once you've done that, we'll use the direct selection tool to tweak to make it more curve like that. You can just scale it up. We're using the handles. Now we'll use one more tool here, Control R, to bring out the ruler and just make sure it's aligned to this point. And again one more like here, and just bring this to this point and this one to there to give it some thickness. And after that, just select the handle and just push it up with the shift press so that it's perpendicular to the angle like that. Now this one will make it more curved. This one will just push it down a little bit here and tweak the handle like that so that we got a nice curve here. Just do it, push it out, and just put this one, just push it like that. You can see it should form a nice curve here. Just pull up the handles. You can just make it a little bit and just push this out so that we got a nice curve here, you can see. And in the same way from the top also, we'll just push this little bit here and like that, and this one little bit like that. So overall, after that, remove the rulers, and once we are left with our text. Now the next thing is to create this other portion. So to create that, we'll use the Ellipse tool, and just from here just shift and drag and bring, make a circle like that. Change the color to something else, maybe some lighter color, and keep this to the little backward. So arrange it to back like that. Now bring it here, just make sure it's the two end points should be overlapping like that. And we can scale it down a little bit if we need the thickness. Before that, we'll make one more stuff here with the rectangle tool. From this point till this point, we'll make that, and just combine both of the objects by going to the pathfinder and just combining it. And again, take this to the back side of the font, and just we'll make sure that these goes down and align with these, and we'll just scale it down a little bit so that you can see the thickness. The thickness of this should be approximately equal to that thickness, so we're just making sure that. And after that, we'll just select these points with the direct selection tool, only these points, and push it up a little bit, aligning that portion. Once you have done that, we'll select everything and go to shape builder tool, and just select this portion, delete it out like that, remove all of this and select these and delete it out. So we are left with these portion. So let's change its color to white so that's more visible. Now once we have made that, the next thing to create is this portion, that's the upper part that look like D. So we'll create that. So we'll use the rectangle tool and from this point to this point just push it up and make sure it's long enough, fine like that. Now duplicate this, Ctrl C, Ctrl F and tilt it to an angle like that and make sure it's aligned like that, and we can just scale it down and make it a little bit thinner as compared to the upper one. We can make it a little more thinner like that. Now select everything and combine it. So once we have combined it, that you can see it's formed the shape of our logo. Now we'll be adding few details, that's this pattern and the creating colors. So to create the pattern, we'll use the ellipse tool, make one small circle here and make sure it's, we'll duplicate this once like that and just bring it down here with the shift press so that it's on the same line and scale it up a little bit like that, and we'll scale this down a little bit so that's like a point. And after that select this, let's scale it up, select both of them, and here this is the part which we'll be using, this is blend tool. So we'll use the blend tool, click once here and once here, and you can see a blending shapes here, and we'll edit that number of shapes we need. So here specify step and we'll be using around seven and preview it. So we need 7 pieces in between them like a blend mode and click OK. So once you get that, we'll scale it down a little bit and we'll make a pattern of it. So just click with the Alt press, just duplicate it once and place it there, and now Ctrl D, Ctrl D, Ctrl D for multiple number of duplication, just do it, and we can see we got a number of pattern here. So once we got all of them, select everything, go to object, expand it. So while we're doing the expansion, it will convert this everything into small objects. Now just combine it and it's act as one object. Now bring it to the front on the top of the shape which we have created. Now copy this once, so Ctrl C, and now this one ungroup it once, and now select that both, subtract it, now Ctrl F which we have already copied, and select both of them and subtract it like that. So we can see we have got that. We can delete this which we unnecessary stuff here. Now you can scale this up a little bit. So here we go, we got that. Now let's fill up the color. This is going to be remaining white. Let's change this color with the art picker, just select the gradient color, and with the grid G just make sure it's on the proper way like that. Now once you have filled up with the colors, last step we are left with is to add the font. So let's use the text, that's the ASK task, and make sure it's white. And for this task we are using Gill San MT. That's, let's check out in the font, we'll type GILL Sans MT and click OK. Now once you have got that, just scale this up according to our logo and make sure it's regular and place it there, give, and make sure it's fit the size of our logo and place it there like that. So we have created this logo in very few steps, and which is going to be the most easiest way. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates on designing, you can press the subscribe button, and also if you like this video, click the like button. Thank you.